In the meantime, the Entity Framework team is working on EF7. EF7 is a departure from EF6 in that Microsoft is rewriting Entity Framework from the ground up. It allows Entity Framework to move forward without being stuck with a very old code base that they were having such a difficult time working with. Because EF7 won't be backwards compatible with EF6 and will also drop some of the features we've had all along, for example, the visual EDMX model, EF7 won't necessarily replace EF6 for many existing software solutions. EF6 will continue to be supported and maintained and updated even as EF7 is released and begins to evolve. Here's how it's going to go. EF6 will still be fully supported. It remains on CodePlex, and the team will be actively working on it, mostly fixes and handling pull requests from the community. Even as the Entity Framework team was going full steam ahead on EF7, they've continued releasing updates to EF6, fixing dozens and dozens of bugs and adding more enhancements from the team and from the community members. They've also released a new version of the EF Designer for Visual Studio 2012 and Visual Studio 2013. And this designer gets automatically installed with Visual Studio 2015. But most of the innovation will go into EF7 for the reasons I've already explained. EF7 is going to enable Entity Framework to move forward in a way that the current base of EF6 just won't allow. The Entity Framework team is totally committed to Entity Framework 6, and the fact that EF6 is open source does give it another advantage. In addition to the team, we developers in the community have an opportunity to continue evolving EF6. Again, while I'm creating this course that you're watching, EF7 has not even been released yet. I created a course early in 2015 called Looking Ahead to Entity Framework 7 so that you can be prepared for EF7 as well as use that information to figure out if and when it will make sense to upgrade existing applications. Here's some high-level points of comparison between EF6 and EF7, but I do recommend that you watch that other course to learn more details. The most obvious is that EF6 is in production, and EF7 isn't in production yet. As a matter of fact, EF7 is going to have a pre-release that comes out when ASP.NET 5 is released, in order for ASP.NET 5 to have a solid data access framework to work with. And then the team will continue adding features to EF7 and bring a little more parity back to what we have access to already in EF6, and then they'll have a full release of Entity Framework 7. That might come out at the end of 2015 or the beginning of 2016, I'm not sure. Both EF6 and EF7 will continue to evolve, although again, EF7 will really get most of the love for new features. While EF7 won't have the visual designer and EDMX support that we've always had up through EF6, there will be third-party designers that will let you continue to use a visual designer even if you are working with EF7. EF6 is backwards compatible all the way through to the first version of Entity Framework. While many of the coding patterns and syntax we're used to using with EF6 and earlier versions of Entity Framework will stay the same for EF7, it's still not backwards compatible. There will definitely be code that needs to be changed if you're moving from EF6 or new syntax and patterns to learn if you're starting with EF7. EF6 relies on the full .NET framework. EF7 can take advantage of the full .NET framework, but it will also work with this new core CLR that's coming along at the same time as ASP.NET 5. EF6 is a single DLL. It's about 6 megabytes. EF7 is going to be broken up into smaller DLLs, so you can pick and choose what you want. This is going to be advantageous for using Entity Framework on smaller devices. EF7, of course, is going to have new and improved and additional features in there. And another interesting thing that EF7 will have that EF6 doesn't is it will support non-relational data. EF6 only works with relational databases. While I also cover this in my Looking Ahead to EF7 course, I just wanted to be sure that you had at least some high-level guidance about working with EF6 or EF7. If you've got existing applications, you won't be forced to move to EF7. Like I've said, EF6 is going to be around for a long time. And because EF7 is not fully backwards compatible, although you can take an app that uses Entity Framework in very simple ways, and EF7 will be able to handle that with no problem. But I would look very closely at Entity Framework 7 and make sure you have good reasons to go through the effort of upgrading an app before you just jump into it. If you've got a large application and there are places where you're doing a lot of work and other places where you really haven't needed to work in those areas for a while, or you don't anticipate having to make modifications to them, maybe focus on those narrower areas where you do think you want to benefit from EF7. Break them apart and put them in their own projects. Use EF7 there. But also keep in mind that you won't be able to use EF6 and EF7
in the same application process.
Definitely wait for the full release of Entity Framework 7, unless you're absolutely desperate for some of the new features and definitely aren't using any of the features like the EDMX and direct work with the Object Context API in your current application. Now, if you're creating a new application, you might definitely be tempted to jump in and start coding against EF7. But remember, EF7 isn't production ready yet. And also, it's a subset of everything we're going to get in EF7. But if you are starting with a core CLR app or using ASP.NET 5 and you don't mind living on the bleeding edge, then yeah, go ahead and start working with EF7. Because at the time ASP.NET 5 and the core CLR RTM and become production ready, so will this pre-release of EF7. Otherwise, if you're starting a new app, I would stick with using Entity Framework 6, but keep Entity Framework 7 in mind, some of its syntax and behaviors, and write your EF6 code as closely to that as you can, so that when EF7 does come out, it'll be a much simpler transition.